Did you know that you can lower your property tax bill by protesting the appraised value of your home and applying for tax exemptions? In Texas, you have until May 15th, or 30 days after the date you get your appraisal notice, to protest your property tax appraisal with the local county appraisal district. The appraisal district in Texas has the job of determining the value of every piece of property in the county every year, which can impact property taxes. Here are the four stages for the property tax protesting process. First, preparation and research. You want to start by gathering information about your property and its assessed value. Part of this involves receiving the protest notice. These are generally sent out in the spring, sometime in March or April. The next, you want to understand the values of other properties in your area. You can do this by contacting local real estate agents, looking at for sale signs, looking on har.com or any local real estate website to figure out the value of other properties in your neighborhood. It's very hard to get you to get your appraisal district to meet with you if you don't meet that protesting deadline. So remember, after gathering your information, file your notice of protest no later than May 15th or 30 days after you get your notice, whichever is later. But getting it done by May 15th will make sure you're safe and the appraisal district will have to work with you. Once you've filed your notice of protest, you're going to have a couple of options on how to move forward, and this is step two. Most appraisal districts will have the opportunity for you to resolve your protest to come up with a value that you agree your house is worth through an informal hearing process. Sometimes this is done online. Sometimes this is done in person. Sometimes it's done via mail. Consult with your local appraisal district to find out what process they follow. If after the end of the informal process, you're still not satisfied or you couldn't come to an agreement, you have the opportunity to have your protest heard by what's called an appraisal review board, or ARB. Every county in Texas has an ARB that handles their protest. At the ARB, these can also be done in person or online. The appraisal district will present evidence, generally in a boardroom or a conference room, saying this is why the appraisal district thinks your house is worth a certain number. You have the opportunity to present your own evidence from the research that you've done, quotes that you've gotten for repairs that need to be done, and other information that you think supports your position on why your house is worth a different number. At the end of the ARB hearing, the ARB board, generally made of three people, will make a decision and put it in writing. They might give it to you at the hearing, or they might mail it to you a week or so later. If you're satisfied, you're done. Your protest has resulted in a lower property tax value. If you're not satisfied, you have the opportunity to go to another level of appeal. You can appeal the ARB's decision by filing a request for arbitration with the state of Texas, or by hiring a lawyer to file a lawsuit against the county appraisal district. Either way, you are saying that you believe the ARB made a mistake. Your evidence shows that your property tax value is different, and you would like another level of review for you to find out what your house is worth. The arbitration process is done through the State Office of Arbitrations. This is in Austin, but generally doesn't require you to go to Austin to be part of the arbitration. Filing the lawsuit against the county appraisal district is done in the county where you live. You're going to want to hire an attorney because this process can be complicated and hard to understand and follow. And you want to make sure you're on equal footing with the county appraisal district. I'm Amir Befroui, supervising attorney and managing attorney of Lone Star Legal Aid's Foreclosure Prevention Project. And I think everyone should know that on average, About 60 to 70% of property tax protests, so people who choose to go through this process, get a reduction in the assessed value of their property, meaning their property taxes go lower. But only about 20% of people with property in Texas who are the owners of the property choose to protest. So I encourage you all to take the first step and protest.